Good morning, dear students. Today we are discussing with the worksheet related to the chapter number 20, that is area of the polygon. So already I have shared the PDF of the worksheet that we are discussing today. Question number wise, all the questions we will discuss here. The question number one, you can also read the question in the worksheet which is shared with you on the Teams. The first question is, find the area of triangle whose sides are, means there is a triangle, the length of the sides are given to us in this triangle, it is 10 cm, 24 cm and 26 cm. Okay, there is a triangle. The three sides of the triangle are given to us, 10 cm, 24 cm and 26 cm. And our question is to find out the area of triangle. Okay, so here we want to calculate the area of this given triangle. So students, as we have discussed in the previous session, that if the three sides of the triangle are given to us, to find out the area, we should apply the Heron's formula. Okay, so I hope all of you know this Heron's formula. Area of triangle equals to under root S, S minus A, S minus B and S minus C. This is the Heron's formula that already we have discussed in the previous session. Now, ABC stands for the three sides. Value of the A is 10 cm, value of the B is 24 cm and value of the C is 26 cm. ABC are the three sides of the triangle. Okay. Now, if we want to apply this formula, first we need to calculate the value of S. Here, S stands for semi-perimeter, correct? S stands for semi-perimeter. So to calculate the value of semi-perimeter, A plus B plus C upon 2. This is the formula, correct? Here, the value of A is 10, value of the B is 24 and value of the C is 26. Addition of all these three gives us 60. It is also divided by 2. So it is 60 divided by 2. That means the semi perimeter is 30 cm. This is our semi perimeter, correct? So once we get the semi perimeter, next we proceed with this formula, area of triangle. Substitute the values. S means 30. Just we calculated here. Value of the S is 30. Then S minus A, that is 30 minus 10. Next, S minus B, 30 minus 24, value of the B, and S minus C, that is 30 minus 26. 30 minus 26. Got it? So here we substituted the values. First, let us solve the brackets. So 30 will remain same. This 30 will remain same. 30 minus 10. 30 minus 10 is 20. Again, 30 minus 24 means 6 and 30 minus 26 is 4. Okay. So these are the values for area of the triangle. Now, let us factorize this. 30 can be written as prime factors of 30. We can say 5, 6 are 5, 6, means 2 into 3. So these are the prime factors of 30. Right? Similarly, we will write the prime factors of 20. The prime factors of 20 is 4, 5, 0. 4 means 2 into 2 and 5. Got it? Similarly, the prime factors of 6, it is 2, 3, 0 and prime factors of 4, it is 2 into 2. So, we have written all the prime factors of these numbers which is there in the square. Now, let us find out the square root of this by clearing the terms. As we can see here, 5 and 5. One pair of 5 is there. Similarly, we can make this one pair of 2. So 2 will come out of the root sign. Again, there is a one pair of 3. So this 3 will come out from the root sign. Then, one pair of 2 and also another pair of 2. So, all numbers are paired. Hence, nothing will remain in the root sign. Then, multiplication of this. 5 2s are 10, 12 means 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12. 12 multiplied by 10. 12 multiplied by 10 will give us 120 square centimeter. Okay, so this is the final answer, 120 square centimeter. Got it? So students, please note it down in your notebooks. Now let us discuss the second question. Question number 2 from the worksheet. The question is, two sides of a triangle are 6 cm and 8 cm. If height of the triangle corresponding to 6 cm side is 4 cm, find the area of the triangle, and also we want to find out the height of the triangle corresponding to 8 cm side. Okay. So, this is our question. Let us understand this question with the help of this diagram. There is one triangle. The two sides are given to us. Suppose triangle ABC is this. The length of the first side is 6 cm and length of another side is 8 cm. Okay. Suppose BC is 6 and AC is 8 cm. Now, what that given us? If the height of the triangle corresponding to the 6 cm side is 4 cm, this is our 6 cm side. The height of this corresponding to the 6 cm AD, it is given to us 4 cm. Okay. Our question, first part is find out the area of triangle. Okay, it is a very simple thing we can calculate here. So, for area of triangle, formula is half into base into height. This formula is applicable because height and base is known to us. Base, consider the 6 and height is 4. 6 multiplied by 4, right? So 2 ones are 2, 3s are 6, 3 4s are 12 centimeters square is the area of this triangle, right? Now, the second part of our question is, height of the triangle corresponding to 8 centimeter side. So, this is our 8 centimeter side. Height of this corresponding to the 8 centimeter, that is E. Okay. So, next part of our question is, when the base is considered as AC, which is 8 centimeter, find out the height for that. Okay. Now, for solving the second part, again we apply the same formula. Area of the triangle is half base into height. Okay. Now, this time, already we calculated the area of this triangle, 12. And the same triangle is there. Area is same. So, area of the triangle, we calculated it in the first part of our calculation. Half as it is. This time, the base we are going to consider as 8 centimeter. And for that, we want to calculate the height. It means we will calculate the length of BE. 2 ones are 2, 2 fours are 8. So 12 multiplied equals to 4 multiplied by H. 4 is in multiply, going that side goes for division. So 12 divided by 4 equals to H. Hence, the value of the height will be 3 centimeter. Is that understood, all of you? Okay. So please note it down in your notebooks. While solving the questions, also read the questions which is shared with you in the worksheet. Then only you can understand it in the better way. Next, we are solving the question number 3 from the worksheet. Question number 3 we are solving. The question is, the base of the height of a triangle in the ratio 4 is to 5. If the area of triangle is 40 meter square, find its base and the height. So in our question, ratio of base and height is given. It is our third question. Ratio of base and height of triangle is 4 is to 5. And also, in the question, area of triangle is also given to us, that is 40 centimeter square. Okay. These two things are given to us, and we want to calculate the base and height of the triangle. Since our question is related with the ratio, so whenever the ratio is there, let us consider that common multiple be x. So let us consider that, let common multiple be x. Okay. So therefore, base will be 4x and height will be 5x. Okay. In the question, area of triangle is given to us 40 centimeter square. So let us take the formula for area of triangle equals to half into base into height. This is our formula, correct? Now substitute the values. Area of triangle is known to us. It is 40. 1 upon 2. Value of the base. What is the value of base? We know 4x. Similarly, what is the height we know? 5x. Is that clear? Now see, 2 is in the division here. 2 is in the division. Going that side goes for multiplication. Got it? And 4x multiplied by 5x. Clear? Now, 20 is in the multiplier. Shifting this side goes for division. So, here it becomes like this. 20 is for division. Okay. Now, students, what will happen here? 0, 0 get cancelled. 2 ones are 2. 2 ones are 2. It means the value of the x square is 4. And we know that 4 is the square of 2. Therefore, the value of x is 2. Is that clear? Now, the question is to find out the base and height. So, what will be the base? 4x. X means 2. That is 4 to the 8. So, here base 4x, 4 into 2, that is 8 centimeter will be the value of base. Similarly, the height is 5x, height is 5x, means 5 into 2, that is 10 centimeter. Okay, so this is the solution for this question. So please note it down in your notebooks. Next, we are solving the question number 4. Next, we are solving the question number 4. The question is, the area of equilateral triangle is 144 root 3 centimeter square. Find its perimeter. So, in our question, area of equilateral triangle given to us, that is 144 root 3 centimeter square. This is the given thing. And our question is to find out the perimeter of triangle. This is the question. Okay. Now see, if we want to calculate the perimeter of triangle, it is necessary to find out the side of the triangle. Then only it is possible to calculate the perimeter. So to find out the side of this equilateral triangle, use the formula for area of equilateral triangle. So area of the equilateral triangle, the formula is root 3 by 4 side square. This is the formula. In the question, area of equilateral triangle is given to us, which is 144 root of 3. Root 3 by 4, side square will remain same. Okay. Now root 3 upon 4, need to shift in the other side. So 4 is in the division, going that side becomes multiply, and root 3 is in the multiply, going that side goes for division. Got it? Now see what will happen. Root 3 will get cancelled. 144 multiplied by 4 equals to sine square. Okay? As we know that 144 is a square of 12 and 4 is a square of 2. Therefore, the value of the side will become 24 centimeter. It means length of the side of equilateral triangle is 24 centimeter. Okay. Now the next question, perimeter of triangle we need to calculate. Therefore, perimeter of triangle equals to, since it is an equilateral triangle, so its perimeter will be 3 multiplied by side. Okay. That means 3 multiplied by 24. So 3 multiplied by 24 will gives us 72 centimeter. So 72 centimeter will be the perimeter of the triangle. Okay. So students, for today we will stop here.